At what point does a board become a mid-length? This is a mid-length, it's in the back. It's almost exactly the same length as this. This isn't a mid-length, this is a different kind of board. So it's, when does a
16 gun. So something closer to that 7 foot range.
Yeah, but this is what I'm saying.
That's close to 7 foot.
That's close to 7 foot, but it's not mid-length. You can get a mini mal, which is 7 foot. Can't break it down.
The shape of it is the function of it. Okay. So if you've got a narrower nose and a narrower tail, it makes the board extremely slow. Okay? So those narrow nose tails that you'll get on a gun, for example, like the pink one, just pull the pink one out. Okay, that's got a narrow tail, narrow nose. So that only gets going when the wave's super, super powerful. Other than that, the board doesn't go fast. It's really, really slow. But on a big, powerful wave, it offers me control. Now a mid-length, for example, you can surf that from, and correct me if I'm wrong, from knee high up to, let's say, well overhead.
This?
Yes.
Yeah, so I've taken...
Where the gun has more curve, that's slightly flatter. It's got more planing area.
Mm-hmm.
Where the gun has a pulled-in tail, that's got a slightly wider tail. It means it gets more lift, more push, more drive. Where the gun has a narrow nose, it's got a wider nose with more volume in the nose. Which means it's a really easy paddler. It's easy to stand up and it cruises. So there's a big difference between the two. That doesn't need a lot of push to get it going. That one does. Okay, let's talk about airplanes then. This is like a Cessna airplane and that's like a fighter jet. It needs a lot of thrust to get that one going. This one will get going on virtually nothing.
Okay. It's gonna be a take two. Clay's going rogue. All I want to do is talk about damn mid-lengths, and he goes off on tangents.
It's a mid-length.
What constitutes a board becoming a mid-length over, say, being a mini-mal or a short longboard kind of thing?
Okay.
At what point does that transition happen? You go, okay, I'm riding a mid-length.
A longboard, you're going to really struggle to take off on a more hollower, critical part of the wave.
Okay.
But where a mid-length, because it's a lot more shorter, you can still surf it a bit more critical.
Okay.
Okay?
Yep.
Whereas with a shortboard, for example, you can turn it really tight in the pocket. These, you kind of, they're flatter, so they've got more glide. They're faster because they're slightly flatter. They're a little bit wider, they give you more time. And it almost slows your surfing down and it offers you enough time to plan everything out. Sometimes people, when they surf shortboards, it's almost like a dog eating breakfast. It's like, and it's just like froth and mess and spit everywhere, and they don't look smooth and clean. When someone rides a mid-length, generally their styles tidy up.
And as soon as you say that, my mind instantly goes Rob Machado, Torren Martin.
Exactly. What do you like about them when you see them surf?
It's like cool, feel. Nice lines, weird. It's like, it looks like it feels nice.
I think people riding mid-lengths are having more fun.
Well, I know that.
And
we'll go into this in a minute. Well, yeah, I'm smiling because I loved riding my mid-length, and you kind of banned me from riding my mid-length, which we'll get into in a moment. But what is it about mid-lengths that you think is making them so popular at the moment? It's like a huge wave of,
okay,
of
so
people. One of
if you're paddling next to guys or one you're in a mid-length, you're looking across that guy and go, sorry, mate. And then you just gliding past him. So you're getting out quicker and you're dubbing your wave counts.
Yeah.
Then when you're out the back, because you're no longer bored, you're picking up earlier on the board. So you're catching waves easier, less fatigued, more waves, equals more fun.
And do you think, I think that there might even be this sort of idea that a mid-length is this next transition as you're stepping down, say from like you're learning to surf, so then you go to, so you've been on your soft top and you go to your mini mal, and then people go, oh yeah, why don't you get a mid length next? But it's, do you feel that it is that process of moving down, or is this just,
definitely that process of moving down. So when I started learning how to surf, so that was in the 80s and the 90s, basically we got hand-me-down surfboards. And those were big single fins that we used to ride. And we used to try to figure out, with no body weight, how to make these bigger board turns. And then trying to figure them out and trying to bury the rail and taking the space you need to turn these boards in, we figured out all the turning. And then when you got into a high-performance shortboard, they were really easy to ride.
Yeah.
So it is a really great transitional tool to get your head around the ideas of the different types of turning that is possible on a surfboard. So the straighter the rail is, the more hold you get and the faster it travels through the water.
Okay.
The more curve your board has, the better it would want to turn, but it wouldn't handle speed well.
Okay, yep. I understand that.
Okay. So with the mid-length, you're inevitably getting more rail, getting a straighter rail line, which is going to facilitate more drive and more speed. But now if you're going really fast and you're driving quicker, you don't need the fin to generate that drive. But on a shortboard where you don't have the straight rail, you've got more curve in the outline, you want the fin to help give you the drive.
It's almost like a sort of waggle, like a fin. Yeah. Kind of like a...
So then on your smaller boards, you want bigger fins.
Okay.
But think about this as well. If you're riding small waves, you want to generate speed. Okay? So because you're going slower, if you've got a bigger fin, when you twist it, you're going to get more drive.
Yeah, okay, I understand that.
Okay. Now the opposite of that, imagine riding a really big board. Right, you're going really fast, which means there's more water passing on the board. So already your boards become stiffer. Because when you try to turn, you're going to displace all that water.
Yeah.
Okay. Now bear in mind, you're also riding a bigger board and some bigger waves, which means it's harder to turn because the board's bigger. Now add on top of that a bigger fin, you're never going to turn that board.
Right.
So going back to the Cessna aeroplane versus the fighter jet, okay? So the Cessna only has to travel at about, I think, 90 kilometers an hour before the wing of it's very wide and it's really thick. So the air goes around the wing and creates lift, and the plane can take off at low speed. But it tops out at about 120. It doesn't go much faster than 120 miles an hour, okay? But a fighter jet won't take off at 90. It has to propel so much faster because it's got smaller wings.
Okay.
But it can travel at, like, I don't know, 500 kilometers an hour, and it can bang and it can turn because the smaller wing space and the thinner wings allow for more control.
Okay.
Does that make any sense?
It does make sense. So a mid-length, in your analogy there of a Cessna versus Cessna, it was Cessna, yeah, Cessna versus fighter jet, what is our mid-length? So Cessna.
It's pretty much a Cessna because it's got a wider nose area, it's got a wider tail area. It's going to plane better and it's going to get more lift and more drive, which means it's probably going to want to surf kind of shoulder, not too vertical, but you can still kind of catch nice big waves on it, right? If you wanted to ride that in bigger waves, you'd want to almost bring the nose width in, pick the nose rocker up, add some tail rocker and pull the tail in. Which means it would go terrible in tiny waves.
And it's just not mid-length anymore?
No, it's not mid-length anymore.
That's a big waveboard.
It's a gun.
Right.
It's your fighter jet, where it only goes when it goes fast. If you're riding a tiny wave, it does not go. It's disgusting. But it offers you control at high speed.
Okay, that makes a lot of sense. So, that's really cool. So let's, obviously we got this blank here. This is a board that's being made for a client of yours. When you're designing a mid-length for somebody, what are some of the key features that you're thinking about in that design? So if somebody was to watch this and they were to go to a surf shop And they were to go, oh, I want to buy mid-length. So they can pick up off the rack and they know what they're looking for. What are the key things? Let's share some real gold with this.
So let me get a straight rule and I'll show you what I'm talking about.
Okay,
so this is a piece of spine tech, but basically, if I hold it down that one side, can you see how there's a bit of a gap over there? Okay, so that's called V. And if I push that side down, that side's got the gap over there. Okay? So basically, what that means is that when you stand on the board, because it's got more volume and it's got more length and it's harder to turn, by putting V on it, simply by leaning a little bit of the toe edge, the whole board rolls, and then you're only surfing half the board.
Okay.
Okay.
Now, I've heard you talking to me about this before, when there's V in the board, and you're saying it makes a wide surfboard feel narrower.
Correct. Because you're either going to surf on a toe edge or a heel edge. Now, if this had concave throughout the whole board, when the board turns, you've got to displace all the water under the concave.
It makes
it harder to turn. But now, I only have to displace that much water. It's an easier board to turn.
So is this a design that's in most of your boards, the V? So in your mid-lengths?
Yes.
So in mid-lengths, you'll run this V through quite a lot of your boards?
Correct.
Okay, cool.
Right. Vs are slower.
Okay.
Continue. Why?
Because that concave channels the water through?
Well, they sit deeper in the water.
Mm.
Okay, if you just think of a catamaran boat, which is almost out of the water.
Yep.
Versus a V boat, which sits in the water.
As more drag.
Correct. But you get more control over it. Now, because it's the mid-length of the flatter rocker and the longer rails, I don't mind it being a little bit slower if I get more control over the turning.
Okay, yep.
Okay. Whereas a shortboard, if I put V in it, it would just be a it'll roll and not go anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
So I put concave in my shortboards, they get lift. And because the boards are short, they're easy to throw around.
Okay, so V is a real good idea for a mid-length. It makes the board feel narrower, even though on your mid-length it might be slightly wider. What else are we looking for? Or what else are you thinking about when you're designing one of these boards?
Okay, so on a bigger board, I always like putting a round tail on. It's like giving power steering to a bus.
Okay.
So let me show you something. Okay, here is a straight...
In my technical terms, it makes it more turny.
Correct. So look here. Imagine I'm going to go. This is where the end of the board is. There. Yeah, so if that was the board going all the way to the end and call it like a squash tail, for example, the water would have to travel down 1 inch, 2 inches, almost 4 inches more rail before it would want to turn.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We're here. The board feels 1, 2, 3, 4 inches shorter because it's a round tail.
So the round tail actually makes a mid-length feel like a shorter board.
4 inches shorter.
What? It's like a magic trick.
So a swallowtail gives you the longest rail line, which gives you the most amount of speed, but it stiffens the board up.
Okay.
The round tail shortens the rail line, which makes your bigger boards turn easier.
Right. Okay, so in your mind, putting that round tail in helps. So now we found a way of making the mid-length not only feel narrower,
goes rail to rail easier.
We've also found a way of making it feel more like you're surfing a shortboard.
Correct. Now on top of that, you got all the paddle power because it's got the volume.
Yeah.
You got the stability because it's got the width, and you've got. Your ability to catch waves easier because it's longer. Okay, so the earlier the wave gets to you, the more lift you get on the longer board and the better it's going to catch waves. So you got all of these pluses that you can tick off, which makes these things so much fun to ride.
Yeah, cool. So now another thing I'm going to ask you about here is there's no fin box as this one here yet. Now Torren is renowned for his riding his twin fins.
Yep.
As a mid-length. When I've ridden my twin fin, when I've ridden my mid-length as a twin fin, I find it really fast and almost hard to control at times, but then that's me surfing. Fin surfs, do you have a preference over twins or quads?
So let's put it this way. Let's put a single fin in here. A Yeah.
Okay, I didn't even mention the single fin.
When you take a fin away and you put it on rail and the V's rolling, the fin's going to almost pop out of the water. You might get the board drift and slide out.
Okay.
Okay. So you have to be heavy off the back foot to keep the fin flat, and you're almost going to do like these 45 degree angle turns. Too much.
That's with a single fin.
And it'll flip.
Okay.
Okay. So you're surfing it flatter, you're planing, and you're doing little adjustments. Kind of way the guys used to surf back in the 70s.
Okay. Yep.
Okay. Put a twin fin on, she's a rocket. She's going 100 miles an hour. You've got to get a lower stance. You've got to start leaning a bit more. Now, when you lean, you've got this big fin giving you hold.
Yeah.
And also, if it's shaped really well, like it says in the plane, it's going to help you project and turn. Okay. Because you're going so fast, the turns are longer, smoother, and drawn out. If you try to go vertical, the tail will drift, release, and you're probably going to fall off.
Mm.
So you can't do short, fast, snappy, vertical surfing. It's the smooth, down the line type surfing.
Yep.
Okay. Put a thruster in. You're able to manipulate it. You can do the sharp turns. You can do the lean turns. You can do off the tail pivot turns. So you've got a multitude of surfing. But it's all up to the user to be able to use it for however it needs to be used, right? If you go quad, you probably have as much drive as the twin, but more control,
less drift.
Okay, so you're gonna get the speed, you're gonna get the drive, plus you're gonna get the turning. It's probably not gonna turn as tight as the thruster where it pivots, but you'll get close enough.
Okay.
Okay, so I love riding mine as a quad.
Okay, so we've covered the width, we've covered the tail. Is there like a standard, if you ride a shortboard at 6 foot, your mid-length should be this length, or is it just...
No, because let's say you're 6'6" and you like riding small boards. Okay, if you ride a 6'6" mid-length, it's not a mid-length, it's your shortboard.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so it's relative to pretty much your height. It's also relative to your weight, like what can... Like, put it this way, if I'm 70 kilograms and you are 106.
Whoa, steady on.
86. Okay, it's a 20 kilogram difference.
Yeah.
You've also got bigger feet than me and you're taller than me. So that means that you've got more leverage.
I'm better looking.
You've got way more leverage on your turns.
Yeah.
Okay, so... You need to be able to use your leverage to turn the boards. So if I try to ride your board, my short feet wouldn't be able to push that rail in as much.
Right.
So I'd be at a disadvantage.
Mm-hmm.
My 20 kgs less wouldn't be able to sink the rail like your board. So I'm at the disadvantage.
Yeah.
And then I don't have the height, which means that you can lean more and get more leverage and I can't. So you have to ride the right mid-length that suits your weight, height, shoe size, all that kind of stuff.
Okay. Is there anything else when it comes to the design of mid-lengths that you feel somebody walking into a shop now that they're going to buy a mid-length? Anything else that they need to know?
Yeah, they're addictive.
They're addictive. Which brings me to the dark side of the mid-length. The dark side of the mid-length. I was having heaps of fun riding my mid-length. My 20, I was taking out every single session. I was loving it. And then
the band guy pals on, guys.
And then you banned me from riding my mid-length.
Yeah. Do you know why?
Well, I do now, but...
You're getting lazy.
So this is one of the downsides of riding a mid-length, is you become lazy.
Well, the other thing is that no matter how ill-positioned you were, you thought you could catch everything. And you're just chinned down and...
Yeah.
All right, whereas on a shortboard, you've got to sit in the right place at the right time, and then you'll be better positioned to catch it. You would be on the worst place, still trying to catch everything, not paying attention to the wave.
Yeah.
Just trying to use the board as a tool to get you into everything.
Yeah.
So you're being a bit greedy, maybe.
All right. This is the official, let's bag Anthony out. Not only is it 160 kilos.
every dude on a mid deck.
You get greedy. You do get greedy.
You out-paddle the person that you're paddling next to. So you get there, and you catch a wave, and you've almost done that 2 to 3 times before you even got there.
Yeah.
And then when he's waiting for his wave, you're just like, well, I can catch it before him. So you tend to get up and leave him behind, and you don't realize that everyone else in the water hates you. But that's a big problem.
Well, this was the first time that I knew that apparently everyone in the water hates you, mate. But no, but it does make, and also another thing there as well, I found myself on the mid-length doing the same thing over and over and over again. I stand up, doing a red bit of speed, I try and do a cutback, I emphasize the word try to do a cutback, and that's what I seem to do all the time, and I never really sort of changed it up.
Yep.
And while it was, don't get me wrong, I feel that sometimes you do just want to go out and just have fun. Yeah. And I think that we need to be really careful in that balance. I know that here at OMBE, we're all about helping people progress their surfing. And sometimes it can seem like we just want you to progress all the time. I think sometimes you do just want to go out and surf for fun. We often go out down the alley on the longboards just for fun, just because it's just to be out in the water.
It's kind of like mindless surfing where you don't have to think.
Yeah.
It's super easy. It's super fun. But over a long period of time, it starts to do some damage.
Yeah.
Whereby you forget where to sit, where to take off, the crowd around you. Like, you're almost in this own little bubble.
Yeah.
And I think by you jumping onto your regular shortboard, you have to improve where you sat.
Yeah.
Where to take off. When you took off deeper, you got way more feeling. Like, you actually could tap into wave energy more and feel it more than you did on the mid-length.
Yeah.
You could surf more vertically, it was more challenging,
yeah.
Potentially more fun, you can get deeper on the barrels on a shortboard. So what are we actually saying about this thing? As much fun as it is, don't fall into the trap of being addictive and wanting to ride it every single session, every single condition.
Yeah.
You should pull it out when you're not enjoying your surfing, or you're feeling a bit erratic and you want to get some flow back into your surfing.
Yeah, I think it's really good for teaching flow. But you're right, they do become really addictive because everything does become so easy. The side effect of that is that you become lazy, and then you end up finding yourself on a Sunday afternoon at Mid-Lengths Anonymous saying,
"My name's Ant, and I'm a mid-length addict. Started about 12 months ago after watching Torn."
With who is a mid-length good for?
Everyone.
Okay, there we go. So a mid-length is good for everyone.
Well, that's like saying, should you learn how to surf a style? Hell yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Should you ride a bigger board and figure out how to put it on rail and use the entire wave face to make these boards fit? Yes. These should have been learned when you were a kid. And if you haven't picked it up, get on a mid-length and figure that out.
Yeah.
It's going to be so beneficial for your style.
Yeah. I've really enjoyed riding the mid-length. I've been banned from it for a while. I will be going back to it again at some point, probably when I'm not surfing with Clay.
What's on your ban list? Don't put into small barrels.
I'm not allowed to put into small barrels. I'm not allowed to ride my mid-length.
No more cutbacks.
Yeah, no more cutbacks. I'm on a full watch list at the moment. Yeah, hopefully that has been really insightful for you. If you are thinking about riding a mid-length, maybe you've been on the fence of, do you actually want to go for one? 100% yes, go for a mid-length. Go in the shop, have a good look at them, put some underneath your arm, have a feel for them, take some of those things into account that Clay's covered there. And if you want to find out more, then we've actually got the Buy the Right Board course, which you can get all details of that inside the OMBE app. You can also get access to the OMBE Method, which is our flagship program, and it is yours completely for free. What you've got to do is click the link that'll be below this video. Is there any closing words that you want to leave us on when it comes to mid-lengths? Or have you... I seriously can't take you seriously with that hat on. But the froth lord.
Well, you said to brush my hair, and I thought this was the easier option.
Yeah, put the hat back on again. Anyway, guys, thanks for tuning in.